Now to a story about a Maryland native who was more than just a politician. Sargent Shriver was a driving force behind the Peace Corps, provided countless support for the Special Olympics, was a Kennedy in law, and once a vice presidential candidate.
And as we first reported at 5 today, he passed away at 95 years old. 11 News reporter Kai Reed spoke with a friend and colleague of Shriver's. She joins us now live in the studio with more. Kai?
Marianne and Rod, Sergeant Shriver announced that he had Alzheimer's disease 8 years ago. Family members say he passed away today surrounded by the people he loved most.
A man dedicated to his country, his family, and to helping those who couldn't help themselves. Robert Sargent Shriver will be remembered as all of those things and more. The lifetime servant died today at the age of 95.
If you met him once, you felt as if you were in the presence of greatness.
Tom Schneidwin, the senior vice president of the Special Olympics here in Maryland, had the privilege of knowing Shriver firsthand. Shriver was his mentor.
I've never met a man with so much charisma, so much charm, and so much innate decency. I mean, I don't know that they make men like this anymore.
Shriver may be best known as the founding director of the Peace Corps. He was also the leader of President Johnson's War on Poverty and made an unsuccessful run for president in the 70s. He became a member of the famous Kennedy family when he married Eunice Kennedy Shriver, who founded the Special Olympics in 1968. He served the organization throughout his adult life.
He was basically the chief cheerleader, the chief bottle washer, the chief entrepreneur. He was the guy who raised the money and made sure that the opportunities were there, you know, to implement his wife's brilliant vision.
Shriver was born in Westminster, Maryland, spent much of his youth here, and kept a presence in the state throughout his life.
You know, Rockville is where Special Olympics was founded, in his backyard. So they had spent, you know, during those times when he was doing the most for this country, he found Maryland to be the place that he wanted to raise his children, and did so.
Schneidwin has held on to several mementos from his time knowing Shriver, including his handwritten notes from one of his speeches in 1994. He says he kept it to show his children and as a way to remember his lasting legacy.
His legacy will be compassion. It will be the compassion of a man who had the ability to hold sway, power at the highest levels, but always insisted, whether it be with President Kennedy or any other national or international leader, that we not forget those that need our services and our support the most.
You can get a look at Sergeant Shriver's achievements throughout the years on our website, WBALTV.com. We've also posted statements on his death from the Special Olympics and local officials, and we invite you to leave your condolences. Again, it's all on WBALTV.com. Just click on local news. Reporting live in the studio, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.